no ha quedat tan igual. Hoynan, Lock, Deutscher, Harley, and the boy go. Oh, well tackled. Well tackled by the crowd, only 21. Hoynan, fine, nice, inside pass. And trying to run through Bolton. Well, now this is Wakefield's chance, no score. And the crowd is sensing possibilities, they're moving the ball about. 25 line, a Wigan's 25 line, you can see. Sampson. The turn has gone on his own. And someone turn is going to give this dummy. He gives the ball a great big swing of it. Now it's not a knock-on. Poynton. This is where Wakefield just slipping, losing the ball at the moment they want it. Round up as the extra man, but Sampson doesn't need him. No score. Getting close to half-time. And the score before half-time is very, very invaluable. A nice kick, oh, the trip, and a penalty, and a caution, and a chance for Fox. And the caution to Lyon. Pick and roll forward, and the referee is going on the field, away on the far side of the field, we've got a man injured. He's coming off now in front of us. Right, he's tried to walk off the field, it would take the goal kick. There he is. There he is. And he's also got attention for number 8. Away he goes on the field for another Wakefield player. Just on our right. There he is, Jack Wilkinson. But that's nothing. Now then, the vital goal kick. 35 minutes gone, 5 minutes to half time. Fox has missed 2 goal kicks. Kick! Well, he made a goal. And he's missed it! Well, what goal kick today? And so that's equal. Ashton missed 3, Fox has missed 3. Well, they're certainly both very unhappy with the goal kick. Which is usually pretty good. It's a good long one by Eric Ashton. Jerry Round to take it. Jerry will try to beat McDonough. Got to go down, Sam. The easiest way. Pierman, and now it's Wigan's turn to get something before the interval. Nil-nil. Fine. Turner, a long one to Sampson. You got into trouble, boy.
Gonna kick in the front. Nothing there, got in that luck.
Beerman, a long one to Brook. Boy, Brook doesn't really seem to show any signs of nerves. First real big match. Poynton. There you go, Harold. Poynton's Graham Frontier. Oh, me, a Turner. Dummy, this is the sort of thing that Turner likes, but he's got no support. He's got to go on his own. He's still going on his own. Can he get his pass in? Well, that's the sort of thing I was telling you about Turner that he loves to do. Now, this is a chance here for Fox. Moving the ball about. This is Wakefield, last chance probably before the interval. Pierman going. 10 yards short. 3 minutes to go to half-time. No score. Wilkinson go the shortest, quickest way.
I don't know about being quick, it'll be the shortest, 100 metres.
But this is Wakefield's chance, just near the half-time. And no, oh, Neil Faulkner, I thought he was going to have a drop. I think he would have done if he hadn't dropped the ball and caught it again. Cosinovi. 20 yards out, 17 yards out for Wakefield. Here's Holiday. Here's Holiday. Here's a try. It's a try. It's a try for Sampson. Given up as a footballer after the car accident, and they're going to take the goal kick, Neil Fox, and if he misses this, well, I'll buy a drink if you ask me. He's kicked it. 5 points to nil, 2 minutes to go to half-time. Well, there you are, Wakefield 5, Wigan 0. And the thing I suggested that it had to unfold down the middle did, with Keith Holiday, the architect, and Sampson backing up very well. Well, that was rather a shattering blow to Wigan, particularly just before half-time. But I know what it's like in the dressing room at half-time, if you're down or if you're up, we make it, there's just 1 minute to go. So there's 1 minute for Wigan to pull something back. Bierman. This will give Wakefield an awful lot of confidence. Passing isn't of the best, mind you. They're a bit slap dash. Can't say slap happy. Turner, Sampson. Wakefield's tactics here would be to hold on and just go down the middle. Keith Holiday, Derek Turner, ill dummy. Ill dummy. Oh, and this is a bad one. And it's Wigan ball now. This is Wigan's chance for the interval. Now Wakefield losing the ball at vital times. Stan McLeod. Can Wigan equalise before half-time? The referee is looking at the Dutch judges who put his flag across his chest to say there's half a minute to go. This is it. There's a chance for Wigan Pitchford. Davis. Roof doesn't get him. Parsley stops him. Well, this is... mounting excitement for Wigan to draw level. They've got a chance here. 5 points to nil for Wakefield. On goes Lyon. He's in with a chance. And the ball is loose and round has got it. And there goes the half-time whistle with a man out, with Lyon. Lyon is out. Just on our right, there is Lyon. So, let's hope he's not seriously hurt. There he is. Jeff Liney went through and was injured. He's got a photographer on the field now. So let's hope that he's not too serious. Boston goes off. He's getting attended to with the chairman. So, well, there it is. And the half-time score, Wakefield at Trinity, 5 points, Wigan, nil. 13 on their side, so obviously Jeff Lyon is an absentee at this moment. Well, let's hope that he's not serious and that he will be back to rejoin. But you are now rejoined us for this last 40 minutes of this Rugby League Challenge Cup final with, no doubt, a lot of fun and good football ready to go. Let's watch the tactics. Is it going to be a long one or a short one? That's the kickoff. There's Mr. Davis going the whistle. It's going to be a long one. Fox is going to take it. And Fox has pushed it over the dead ball line. And the idea now is that it's a drop out from the 25 line. And Wakefield have as much chance of getting the ball as Wigan. That's the tactics for that. So 5 points to nil if you've just been out to have that cup of tea and get yourself comfortable again. Fine day. Then China wait for Wigan ball. And Wigan have now got a mighty job on their hands. And Wigan are a mighty side. That's two mighty sides today who have pushed all their Holmes of might into this one. I keep looking towards the... Oh, wait a minute. That's number 12. What's that 12 over? Well, who's missing? Back. Carlton. There goes down, Mr. Wigan. Chance for Wigan. Chance for Pitcher. Pitcher's going to score. Pitcher's going to score. Pitcher scores.
McLeod has gone full back for Wigan, and I'll tell you the formation of the middle men when we get it sorted out. McLeod and hold the possession. Then at high three, how close it could have been. Very little. By Barton. Holiday. Now the next try is going to be also important. Lyon making the tackle. Number 12, Atana. Atana is now coming to his own a little bit in the second row. Haven't seen the scrums, so I don't know whether they switched, but we'll soon find out. Thompson, the boy who got the try. Two tries, one goal in it at this moment. One kick by Fox, the easy one. Inside to Wilkinson.
He's going to have a drop.
Missed it. Well, the crowd are booing a bit. I don't know what for, but anyway, it's no go. And we're going to have got 12 men. Bolton is in the dressing room. And we have just had confirmation that he has got concussion, but he's hoping to be back. There's a penalty for Wakefield for a shove in by Collier. Collier looks in great disgust at the division. Neil Fox, who recently, just 1 minute ago, missed a drop of goal with a chance to get 2 points. Very acute angle. Hey. following Greenwood. A very little chance in the match so far. Greenwood. Lyon. There, Roy Evans. Roy Evans, the butcher from Wigan. Brad McTeague, the collier. Collier, by name and profession. I don't know why I should call McTeague a minor and Collier a collier, but still, must be reason. Barton. Now this next four, whichever side, if there is one, is going to be a very, very vital and could be a deciding one. Oh, a chance now for Frankie Carlton on the wing. Carlton can hold. Dutch judge and he wasn't playing. Well, 5-3 and 7 minutes gone and McLeod pulled back. I'm now trying to get the position right. Roy Evans is standoff and Davis and Ashton centre. So they've made the least of their troubles by moving just two positions. Lyon, the dummy half. The dummy half now. Evans, Roy Evans. Referee calls out, they've got to let the player stop on the floor. And he must have had his player stop there. Collier to Lyon. Shadows, not a bit cast now. Oh, that pass. Oh, and Bowles and Brooks got it. Try to either team is important. Point then. It's a chance for Koitsa. Chance for Koitsa. Chance for Koitsa. It's a try for Koitsa. Hooper, they call him at Wakefield. Gert, they call him. We call him all sorts of names. We call him a jolly good try scorer there. And that puts Wakefield 8 points to Wigan 3 points. And Wigan, 10 minutes gone almost. And Wigan labouring under the handicap of having only 12 men at Davy Bolton off. And we've got our eyes on the tunnel as well. We'll let you know if the side is coming back, but it's no chance for Fox. It couldn't be harder. It's on the touchline side. It's the 25. It's made a bit of a mess of a field so far as Neil Fox, but here he goes again. And he kicks it! There he is, Neil Fox, who is sending a signal for something. I just telling the colleague to move closer up into position. That's all right. 10-3 for Wakefield. Wakefield 10, Wigan 3. Point of view, they are forcing home the advantage of having one extra man. There goes Fox.
to Brook. Now this is Wakefield opening up in a very confident manner. Turner. Vine. Vine and Billy Boston, two Welsh nuts. Then they can see open up. I've been told this is a chance for Wakefield to make the overlap with a good cover. Point and inside again. Dummy. Oh, who's got it? Wiggins got it, I should think, yes, following referee Dennis Davis's movements. Now Wigan are just a bit rugged at the moment. Wakefield are moving in rather strongly, despite the try by Pritchard, which must be offside. And it's a lead for Wigan. Now then, the might of Billy Boston and Eric Ashton must now be used to bring Wigan back into this game. They're quite capable of doing that. A lot of good footballers on the Wigan side. A lot of good ones on the Wakefield side too today. And the Lancastrians in the crowd, at least the Wiganers, are now appealing to their heroes to come on with it, Wigan, shall we say. Pitchford to feed, the boy that got the try, good solid scrum that. We're seeing it from the blind side. Roy Evans and Alan Davies. Wigan had only one try scored against them in their four rounds of play. And they've had two scored against them today. Got to use now the Wigan captains, Ashton and Boston, if they can, and Ashton sensing that and telling them to go his way, and they are doing. Just had news from our man on the spot that Bolton will be back, and he will be back within a couple of minutes. So that should be the first time you'll hear about it. Will be the roar of the Wiganers, because David Bolton is a very important part in the Wigan machinery. David Bolton coming back to bring Wigan up to their 13. He's a bit shaken, but strong boy, David Bolton. And he's an important part. He's walking round, so he has to get him used to the air and the what have you. Oh, we got to that very quick. I'm talking with Roy Evans. 10-3, 7 points in it. 15 minutes gone in the second and a half, so there's just 25 minutes to decide where this Rugby League Challenge Cup is going to go for his 28th Wembley final. First place for the Cup in 1895. Wilkinson didn't play then, but he's been in five finals. And he packed the Jack on the floor. Get up, Jack, another goal. Bolton walking round. I would imagine probably going to sit on the bench a while. I'll just keep walking. Yes, he's going to sit on the bench. He's got Chris Jenkins, the coach, has sent word on. He's going to be on soon. They both broke his arm playing in collarbone, playing in Australia on tour recently, or last week at one, Evans. halfway line.
Wembley halfway line.
Collier, interception now by Dillon. Here we go. Nice done. One inspiration from either Boston or Ashton could put Wigan right back into it. But Wakefield has got a pretty tight hold at the moment. McTaig, lost ball. Advantage. No, Wigan has still got it. And the penalty to Wigan. And there's this on the ground. Jeff Lyon, number 12, shoulder. Well, the injuries, which usually come out about equal, I would imagine, are not equal today at the moment. With Bolton on the touchline side and Jeff Lyon getting a bit of special Wigan warfare. Well, Wigan have come from their own line practically now to almost the 25 line. And that second cheer denotes the arrival on the field of David Bolton, who's now gone to his fullback position. So it's Wigan now at full strength with 20-odd minutes to pull this game out of the fire, which at this moment has been Wakefield 10, Wigan 3, and it's another penalty for Wigan. So Eric Ashton will take the goal shot, I'm quite sure. And if he kicks the goal, then fireworks will follow. No goal has been kicked yet by Wigan. Two have been kicked by Fox. And I wouldn't like to say which way the wind is blowing, but Eric wanted to get direction with that, hence he's placing the ball long ways. 10-3, remember. It's a goal! No, it's it! Well, 10-5. And we have got left for play. 21 minutes, so I wouldn't stop predicting at this moment what's going to happen. Wakefield 10, Wigan 5. And Wigan crowd now feeling happier with a full side. 13 and against 15 in rugby. It's going to be a long one by Neil Fox. And Eric, you're a big lad, we're not big enough to catch that. Again, the pattern, put in the ball over the dead ball line, so they've got a chance for the dropout. This sort of tactic was first introduced by a touring team I was with about two years ago, and very successfully, and these players who've been on tour now adopt it. Who's going to get it? Let's have a look. Dropout, of course. Too tense for me to give you a lot of record of what Boston others have done, because this cup final now is really reaching the boiling point. Teams are now standing well back to avoid penalties, and this is a chance.
This is a chance for Neil Fox. He's going to have a drop now. He isn't. He's going to pass it. Oh, this is a chance for Gottkreutz. Sampson's gone in the wrong way. Sampson turns.